Hello, hello, guys. Happy Monday. Thank you for coming in tonight. Thanks, replay viewers, for watching. And thank you, YouTube viewers, for watching as well. This is up on YouTube, or it will go up when I'm done here, at Penguin and Fish Movies on YouTube. And it will also stay on the Penguin and Fish page on Facebook. So thanks again for watching. Block 90, I'm starting tonight, guys. Crazy. I can't believe we're already on block 90. So here we go. I'm going to flip you around and we'll get started tonight. Hey, guys. Thanks for coming in. Happy Monday. Block 90 of the Splendid Sampler Quilt Along. It's called Juggling. Look at all the cute little balls and the little string. It's a quite the block. I had to read through the instructions a few times, and I also looked on the website. It's by Lorena Uriarte. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that quite right, but if you go to thesplendidsampler.com where this project lives and go to the blog, there will be a link to the designer's blog where she talks about it. And that was really good for walking me through the process a little bit, and so I'm going to be doing that here as well for block 90 of the Splendid Sampler. You can find more info on this sew along at thesplendidsampler.com. And we're on block 90. It's out of 100 blocks, so we are in the home stretch. I cannot believe it. We are almost done with these Splendid Sampler blocks. If you're new here, my name is Alyssa Thomas from Penguin and Fish, where we make lovely and quirky hand embroidery patterns and kits. I'm the author of Sew and Stitch, Embroidery, and a Fabric Designer, and I'm here every weekday at 9:30 p.m. Central. So thanks again for coming, guys, and hello, everyone. I see everyone popping in here. That's awesome. All right, I'm going to flip you around, and we'll get going right away. I kind of have a plan for this. Yeah, Carol, I was a little confused at some things, but I looked them up on that blog post, and it cleared it up a little bit for me, so we'll go through those here. So, all right, guys, I'm going to flip you around. Here we go. Oh, Judith, that's awesome. I've endured because of your guys' help, too, that's for sure. I've learned so much from working on the Splendid Sampler quilt along, and, man, I learn stuff almost every block. So, all right, here we are. So what this block is made up of is basically three circles and a bias tape that we're going to make and applique on, and then we're going to applique these circles on. But these circles are made up of this fun way of piecing where we slash our shape in half, and then add a little strip in the middle, and then slash it again and add another strip. So, they all look hard. Yeah, it's just one step at a time, and we're getting through it. And that's what we're going to do here, too, just one step at a time. So, my plan for tonight is, before we get too far, I want to take these templates. So, there's three templates for the circles. She suggests using that template plastic. I don't actually have any template plastic, so what I'm going to use instead, and hopefully this works, I'm going to use, I have a couple postcards of mine here, and I'm going to just, I'm going to cut the circles in these. It's a little thicker since it's a postcard, and I'm hoping it's thick enough to kind of do the job. So before we get too far, I'm going to start there. And to do that, I'm going to cut out these circles from the paper, trace around them, and then cut them out from the postcards. And I think that will get me what I need for the template. And then what I thought we would do, once that's out of the way, is we'd get started on these circles. So the circles are actually made out of, we need to cut 4.5-inch squares. And then we're going to take the square and slash it in half and then sew a little strip into it. And then we're going to cut it in half again. So I'll show you. We'll kind of go through that process tonight. So here's my fabric plan. It looks like way off of my normal fabrics because usually, you know, I'm doing all these blues for my quilt. And this is a lot of reds. And the reason I'm doing a lot of reds is because I need a big piece for the background, and I need kind of bigger pieces for the rest of it. And I am totally running low on my fabric for the Splendid Sampler. So these are pieces that I actually had that were big enough to still have a big piece in the background. And I thought it'd be fun. We do have red in the quilt, so, you know, we'll throw another red one in. So here's my plan. I'm going to do this crazy one for the background. We haven't really done this for a background yet, and I still have a bit of it. And then I'm going to do these reddish, orangey fabrics for my circles. I know it's going to totally blend in and sink into the background because they're so close to the background as far as, you know, how dark. I mean, this one especially, it's like the same darkness, light and darkness, you know, it's at the same value level as this background. So it's not going to really be all that visible, but I kind of like that. I kind of like that my three red and orangey circles will kind of blend into this to make, you know, almost like it's a red square. They're not going to be like so called out, and I think that's good for this one for me. And then I went through my scrap bin, and I found, I think, just enough scraps that will work for the little colored slashes through all of these. So all these will get like some fun little slashes of color. And then for the bias tape, I think I'm going to use this dark blue just because I have a lot of it, honestly. It's because I have enough to do the bias. Because for bias tape, you want to cut on a diagonal. And I have enough fabric to do that. Yes, so Joza's saying, did you see the additional tutorial on the designer's blog? I did. I did actually go to that because I wasn't sure about a few things in this design, and that was very helpful. So I suggest going to, it's Lorena Uarte. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that right, but you can go to the splendidsampler.com, and on this block, there will be a link to the designer's homepage, and then you have to actually click on her blog page from her homepage. It took me a little while to find it, because the homepage looks like a blog, but it's not. So you have to go to the blog page on hers. And then there was a very, very detailed description on how to do this block, so I'm kind of using that as a guide. So I definitely recommend doing that. But for us to start out, like I said, I'm going to just scooch all this off to the side, and I'm going to just start by prepping my circles. And all I'm going to do, I made a copy of the circles here, and I'm going to just quickly cut these out, and then I will transfer these to my postcards. And the reason I want a thicker piece for my template versus just using this cutout, this, you know, normal printer paper as my template, is because we want something thicker so that we can, when we're done making our shape, we want to pull the shape around our template to give us a nice edge to our circle. So this is like the back of the circle on the template. And then when we turn it to the front, we'll have like a nice edge. But we need, you know, a good stiff piece of paper or template to wrap, to be able to pull on the outer edge of, you know, bunching the outer edge around the circle so the circle doesn't move around, doesn't fold and stuff. So that's why we want something thicker. And, you know, that's why it's usually typically done with template plastic. But I don't have any of that. That's a little fancy for me. If you do a lot of appliqued quilts, though, it's probably totally worth getting some of that plastic because, especially if you're doing a design where you have a lot of the same applique pieces over and over again, getting some template plastic and cutting it out is probably worth it, worth finding some of that. But we're improvising, so again, I'm just going to cut these out and we'll trace them onto my postcards. And then we'll get sewing. We'll get sewing those little rectangles. So the tricky part of this design, for me at least, I think is going to be the bias strip. The designer talks about a bias, what is it called? Another tool I hadn't heard of before. Oh, a bias bar. So it's a way to press the bias tape and get the seam out of the way. So kind of interesting. We'll look at that. I think you'll glue the circles to the postcard. Oh, and cut them up. Oh, funny. So you got a postcard for me? That's awesome. Yeah, the a bias bar. So what, I had never heard of that before. So what it looks like, I think, this is why I went to the designer's page, because I wanted to find out what that was. And it looks like it's just a flat piece of metal that you put into basically the bias strip, which is like, it'll be like a tube. And then you rotate the strip on that bias bar so the seam is out of the way, and then you press it flat. I don't have one of those, and I don't have she says that you can make, oh, in your book, oh, awesome. She said you can make one with the template plastic, which I don't have. So maybe we'll try and use a postcard for that, but I think you kind of need a long something for that, but I don't know. I'm leaving that for another day. I thought we'd start here, and I'll figure that out. So, all right, guys, I grabbed three of my postcards, and I thought I'd make them cute. So let's, put these on like little faces. So, okay, I'm just going to draw around one of these and we'll cut it out. So I'm just transferring those circles that we just cut out. You use glue stick to fix the circle page to the cardboard page. Oh, well, that would have made sense, Marilyn. Instead of cutting this out, I cut these circles out and now I'm tracing them on. I could have just glued these onto the front and cut this and the postcard out at the same time. But, oh well. That's pretty smart, though. That would have saved me some time. But, we're doing it this way now. So now I'm trying to cut out as best of a circle as I can, because this is going to be the actual edge of our circle. It's going to butt up right against this circle edge. So whatever I do here is, in theory, what it's going to look like. And I don't know if I'm doing that good of a job of cutting a circle. It's a little hard to cut out of this thick postcard, but I suppose it'd be a little hard to cut out of template plastic too, maybe, I don't know. I think you can just get template plastic at like Joann's or something like that. Or I don't know, your local quilt shop might have it too. I don't know for sure. I know I've seen it before, but I've never used it for anything. Kind of fun, I think. I think what it is just like a cuttable plastic, but then it's easy to draw shapes. All right, here's this one. I'm going to actually write on the back that it's a 2-inch circle, because then maybe I can actually use these again. 2 inches. All right, next up, let's do, I think this one will, let's do a little hedgehoggy face out of this one. Oh yeah, or like a Hobby Lobby or something. And I'm sure you can order it online. But if you have a postcard or a thick piece of paper, I think that'll work too. I'm hoping it will. Okay, let's cut him out. These are cute little circles. This is another reminder for me at how small these blocks are, because in my head these circles are way bigger, but they're not. They're teeny tiny still. So Saturday, Saturday, you know, I wasn't here over the weekend. I kind of decided for 2017 that I was going to try my best to not do work on weekends. Not that this is, you know, really work, but, you know, just doing stuff, basically doing nothing all day, or just like kind of just relaxing or hanging out with family and whatever. So that was going to be my goal for 2017, is I was going to try and lay off the work on the weekends, since that's pretty abnormal for me to not be working on something or not think I have to be working on something on the weekend. So, you know, on a Saturday, I was thinking, okay, I'm not going to work on stuff, but I want to do the laundry and clean up, you know, the house. I'm going to do this right in the middle here. And all that stuff. And what I ended up doing, you know, so in my head, I'm like, okay, I'm taking off. And I woke up, I read my book for a little, ate some breakfast, and then I fell on, or I fell asleep on the couch till 4:30 p.m. So I slept the entire day away. And then I woke up and tried not to feel guilty for the rest of the day for doing exactly what I said I was going to do, which was nothing. It was just totally goofy. I wasn't expecting to do that at all. And but then I woke up at 4:30 and I actually still got a ton of stuff done. I still did the laundry and I vacuumed and I cleaned up a little and cooked some vegetables, or like, you know, roasted some vegetables and stuff. So I still did almost everything I wanted to putz around on Saturday. Oh yeah, that's right. I got to mark the back of this. This is a 2 1/4. I'll do that when I'm done here. Thanks for the reminder. But yeah, just completely slept all day. And I don't nap hardly. I don't know, maybe I am a little bit more lately. I don't know what the deal is, but like, man, I slept all afternoon and it was awesome. But then I'm like, oh man, I should have done this and this, and I can't believe I slept that long. And then later I'm like, but wait, I said I was going to do nothing today or just relax today. So I had to keep telling myself to shut my brain off and not feel bad about not doing tons of stuff. So it was kind of weird. It was a weird experience for me. But it was good. Got a lot of sleep in and cleaned up over the weekend and got, you know, stayed away from the computer, and that was pretty good. Pretty good feat for me. I don't do that very often. Yep, we definitely need it sometime. You're right, Antoinette. All right, so this one was the 2 1/4. 2 1/4 inch. And I know I totally need more days like that. I'm feeling it now, like, that, like, oh, I should just, I need to do that more often. And you know what? I think I might be on the verge of getting a cold, too, and I'm trying to convince myself that it's not a cold. And drink a lot of tea. So on Sunday, I ended up moving a lot of stuff around, and I think I kicked up a pile of dust, and I think I might be feeling a little sick from that. Like, it's not actually a cold. I think it might just be dust, so I'm hoping that's the case. All right, guys, we got our 3 templates. Oh, so cute! But, okay, I'm hoping I can save these for later. We'll see how it goes. Okay. I'm going to set those aside, and next up, let's start our circles. So to do the circles, I'm not cutting them all the different sizes off the bat. I'm going to do what the directions say here. So I'm going to cut 4.5 inches square out of each of my 3 fabrics for the balls. Those are these. So let's start there, and then what I'm going to do is these are for my scrap bin. I'm going to just trim these. For the strips, the strips are supposed to be like 3/4 of an inch by 5 inches. I don't think that has to be as strict as that, because we are, it's kind of a scrappy little, you know, these little strips every which way. So I don't think it's going to matter if some are thicker and some are a little thinner. So what I'm going to do is, you know, some of these are a little skinny. I'm going to cut, you know, make a clean edge, and then I'm going to just do a parallel edge to that. If it doesn't end up being quite 3/4 of an inch, then I'm going to be okay with that. Just because I don't think it's totally necessary. And I'm not even going to worry about trimming it down to the 5 inches either. I'm just going to get some straight strips. And you'll see why I don't really need to have them be so perfect in a sec here. But let's do some trimming. All right, I need about 4.5 inches of each of these. And technically, I probably don't even need that much, but I thought we'd stick to the instructions a little bit. And you know what? I'm not even going to clean up these edges, I don't think. I wonder if this is 4 inches here. Let's get the ruler out. Nah, that's only 3.5 inches. See, look, I'm almost out of fabric. Maybe I can... I'm going to have to fussy cut this one a little bit. So I guess I'll get my 4.5 inches out of this one about here. And this guy here. So on her blog post, I think she actually used this fabric, but the black version of it. So that was pretty cool, I thought. So I'm going to use that in mine too. The same, the one that I keep saying looks like a Bic pen that someone just drew zigzags on. I kind of love this fabric. All right, so I am going to just square this up quick just because I need to chop off this big piece anyway. So, all right, 4.5 inches or so. 1, 2, 3, 4, about to there. There we go. All right, now I'm gonna got a nice big piece of scrap there. Let's just rotate this around. I'm actually gonna just turn it a little and hopefully I can cut both ways. So let's get that 4.5 inches. Again, this doesn't really have to be perfect for this. Oops. I can't reach around that way. I'm going to have to. All right. Hopefully this works. My arm's like wrapped around the phone right here. Okay. So there we go. Perfect. So we're done with those. I like when we get done with fabric. All right, here is what our circles are going to be. These three fabrics here. So I'm going to set this to the side, just for a moment here, and I'm going to just trim up a bunch of little strips for my scraps here. So let's start with an easy one. You know, I could press this, but I think this one's thicker anyway. So let's just get a couple of clean edges here. So we only need them to be 3/4 of an inch. So let's get a good edge. And where we can, we'll do 3/4 of an inch. We might actually be able to get 3/4 of an inch out of all of them. Oh, it's funny. Yeah, when it's super hot. In the Australian stuff now. I know, I had to put on 3 different long-sleeve shirts today. It was just kind of so silly. I have, I had 3 sweaters on, and the outer one was a wool one. Right now I have 2 sweaters on. It's a little ridiculous. Oh, I know, Judith, I am itching for that rotating mat that needs to be here now. It probably won't be here for like a week or so. I just ordered it. So here we go. Here's one of our strips. I'm not going to worry about the ends. I think this is fine. So let's do the rest of them here. I feel like this one's not very long. Oh wait, this doesn't... Well, This isn't like really very long, but I'll use this for my smallest circle maybe, and we'll just see what happens. I might actually cut it off of this side because I have a little bit more here. So let's get a good straight edge here. I know that rotating one would be nice. The rotating mat, I wouldn't have to keep turning my fabric like this. I could just rotate the mat instead, and I wouldn't have to keep adjusting my fabric, which is, you know, would be beneficial. All right, 3/4 inch right there. So we got kind of a longish piece out of here yet. For this one, I'll definitely have to treat it as my shortest piece. We'll just kind of see how that goes. That was 2 strips. Let's do this yellow piece. Again, here's a kind of a short one, but it's not, I don't think, gonna matter. Hopefully. We'll figure it out. It's fun to use scraps, though. I'd like to keep using up my scraps here. Should have gotten that tourney mat a whole long time ago. That would have been. Did I get that one right? I think I might have moved a little bit. I think it's fine. But that would have been helpful a long time ago. All right, this is an odd shape. Let's see what we can do with this. Nice edge here. That I don't have any weird nicks. Nope, we're good. All right, so this one, I'm not sure if I'm going to have 3/4 inch the whole way. So I'm only going to be able to use this bottom part. But my mom just popped in. Hello. But why cutting 3 1/4 inch pieces? This is for the strips that will be going down. So each of these circles gets like a funny strip out of it. So I'm just cutting, these are for those strips. It's a 3/4 inch. All right, so here I'm just gonna, this is where that nick was. I'm just gonna cut it off there. And technically they should be 5 inches long. According to the instructions, but I'm using scraps, so I'm just going to try and make it work with whatever length I have here. Like, this one's not going to be 3/4 inch the whole way either. This one I might actually on purpose do a little thinner, so I can do the whole length. So this one's going to be... This one's gonna be a little skinnier, which might be a little goofy, but oh well. But you know, you can do different widths and everything for this. This is kind of like the collage-y sort of artsy part of it, I suppose. That's not the best term for it, but where you can go, you know, be a little bit more creative, I think. Slice in any direction and stuff. We'll do that next. So next up is we're gonna start sewing. All right, this might be just enough for that 3/4 inch. All right, scraps gone. There we go. So I just want to kind of match things up again. First of all, I suppose we kind of have to, Well, I kind of had it laid out like this, so let's just keep it going like this. So I'm going to have this be big, medium, and small. I think so. These longer ones I wanted to put with the large one. Yeah, I think that'll be good. And this one will have that one and this long red one. See, so it'll kind of, our circles will kind of end up being like that. And then this one, I got a little bit of a shorter one in here, but that's okay. So, okay, let's start with the long one. So long or large, medium, small. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna just cut, we're gonna just cut this kind of wherever we want. So that's kind of the fun part of this. You just slice this in half. And it doesn't really matter, I think, what direction really. It says cut across each 4.5-inch square fabric and insert a 3/4-inch strip. So we don't, it doesn't have to be perfect. See, like, here's a good example. So they crossed it this way and then this way. It doesn't have to be a perfect 90 degrees or anything like that. So I'm going to just cut this somewhere, you know, in the middle a little bit. I'm going to go right here because then I'll get some of this blue in it. And hopefully this will work. You could just go right across. But see, we're just cutting our square. And now I'm going to insert, let's do this one first, maybe. I'm going to sew these two together, right? So we're going to get a little strip there, and then we're going to sew this fabric to it, and that's how we're going to get like a fun little strip in the middle. And then we're going to cut again in a different direction, and that's where we're going to insert the other strip. So that is the plan. So let's sew these. Kind of a fun little trick here. There's a lot of cute little fun things in this block, I think. So I'm gonna just put right sides together and sew my scant 1/4-inch. And again, I'm cutting a circle out of this when I'm done, so I'm not worried about these outside edges very much. So you don't have to worry about those that much either. All right. And really, I could do all three at once, but let's do one first just to see how it goes, and then we could do these other two at the same time. Chain piece the other two. But for this first one, we'll do it like this. Okay, so we are going to need to get the iron going. So let's press this. I think, what way did they want us to press? Oh, press the seam flat. Oh, this must be the outside. So, okay, we're going to press it to the larger area, I think is what that means. So let me clean up my ironing board. Here we go. So I want to press it towards that outside fabric, which means I want to put it on top of here. There we go. Sometimes it helps to finger press. Hold on, guys. I'm going to lose one of my sweaters. Getting warm by this iron there. Now we're down to one sweater. That's a first for the day. It was a 3-sweater day today. I'm not kidding. It was coldy in the house. All right. So there we go. That is our first little strip there. So now we're going to sew on the other side here. So we just did that one. Let's get this guy on there as well. So again, I'm just going to put right sides together again. Good. We're basically sewing our square back together. We slashed it down the middle and sewing it back together. We just stuck a strip in the middle though too. Oh, that always warms you up. Oh, see, that's a good idea. You know what? I did not do my workout that I was supposed to do today, Donna. But I'm doing it tomorrow, early afternoon. And mostly because just this afternoon, like, I was really hit with that that kind of cold feeling. Like I'm catching a cold. So I just, I napped and drank a bunch of water instead. But I am planning on doing it tomorrow to make up for today. So tomorrow is legs and cardio, and then on Wednesday it'll be arms again. So make sure to check in with me and see that I did that. But there we go. So we have basically that square, and we've kind of inserted this tiny little strip. It's just so kind of funny. Yeah, it's totally like blob sewing. We're totally just sewing some blobs. So now we can, now we're going to do this exact same thing and insert another strip. This one gets a little funny because we do have to, when we cut it, we do have to somehow visually match up these lines again. And we'll give that a try. But, you know, now this one, it doesn't have to be like a perfect 90 degree angle. Like that would be kind of 90 degrees. It can be kind of any which way. I think I might go, I don't know, that's kind of cool. So let's just chop right down there. Again, just grab your ruler. I know, after that rest day of Saturday, I wonder if that was like a preview of maybe, hey, you might get sick soon, so maybe you should just nap here a little. So I don't know, maybe that's what my Saturday was. And yeah, I was just feeling not great today, and I'm like, I better hold off. But I'm definitely doing it tomorrow. You know what? Sunday, I didn't drink a lot of water. I didn't drink as much water. So I've been drinking a ton today. And I'm thinking that'll help me tomorrow. And tomorrow, I'll drink tons of water, too, before I work out. Oops. That was already on. I don't need that as long. We'll go right here. All right. But it's happening, Donna, for sure. It has to. And, you know, I can't always just be like, oh, I don't feel good. I'm not going to work out. I got to figure out something to keep me doing it. Your husband's legs got hurt. Oh, when he starts getting sick. Oh, yeah, okay. That's not cool. Yeah, so I knew how I was feeling a little bit today, so I just kind of took it a little slow and drank a lot of water, and I'm hoping that does the trick. Got a little extra here. All right. So I'm going to press this first, and then here's the trick. We gotta match it up so that, you know, we can't like put this anywhere, right? Because when we're done, we want it visually to look as if this is connecting. So we might do a couple of our pin tests. Oh, good night, Debbie. Thanks for coming in. So I'm gonna press this flat again. Oh, you know what? I did not do the grading of my seams. Oh well, it's too late now. I'll show you what that is though on the rest of this. So let's get this one done. But yeah, so there was the suggestion to grade. Oops, I'm pressing. Oh no, I'm not. To grade the seams to kind of reduce some of the bulk. And I was going to show you guys what that meant, but I already screwed it up. But I can show you with this new block. It's tough pressing this first one. All right. So that is our first side. So let's do the other one first. Okay. So I'm going to do our little pin test here. So here's the thing. Let's turn this off. So the color's better. I want this purple line to look like it's matching, going in one straight line underneath this red line when I'm done. So that means I don't want to accidentally put it here or here because, you know, then it won't look like it's lining up. And it plays a trick on you. So, like, because you have to consider that you're going to get rid of a quarter inch seam allowance on either side. So I can look at it and be like, oh, it looks like it's going to go right there. But when I flip this over and then pin it, so let's just do a test. I'm going to pin it there about a quarter inch in. And I'm just guessing on that quarter inch. And let's put another one down here. I need a... And all my pins are bent. It's time to get a whole new batch of pins, I think. Okay, so here's kind of my quarter inch, my fake quarter inch. So now I'm going to pretend so. But look, see how far off that ended up being? So you don't want to line up your line without taking into the consideration the seam allowance, because look, it jumped way up there. So that's why we did the test. So what we're going to have to do is let's just scooch it down a hair. And we'll test it again, and we'll stop when we get close. And actually, in the in her instructions on the blog, she actually does it this way, and then sews right there first. Doesn't sew from one end to the other. She'll just sew this area and fold it over to see if she got it. So she doesn't have to rip out the whole thing. She only has to rip out a little. See, so that's a little bit better. I was just thinking if there's a different way to do this. Like, what I usually like doing is kind of just marking my fabric, but we'll keep going this way. Let's put it down a little bit more. And again, I'm guessing on my quarter inches too. So let's go down a little bit more. And if it's not perfect, I'm not going to bother too much. But here, we can just kind of go in and out a couple times instead of two pins. There we go. Like that. That's about a quarter inch. There, that's not looking too horrible. I think we just do it there and, well, you know what? Why don't we do the test like how she said? So I'm going to just sew right over this edge and, do that, but you know what? Ah, never mind. Yeah, I'm just gonna do this now. I was gonna do. I still had time to do the grading on here, but I'm just gonna do it this way. We'll talk about that next. All right, I'm gonna get this starter out of my way. Okay, let's test that one little bit. See if we got this in the right place. There, we just tested that one little area. This is a suggestion on her blog, so I've never done this before like this. That'd be fun to try. All right, so I didn't sew across the whole thing. We were just testing that, and hey, that doesn't look half bad, right? I think that looks good enough. I'd say let's just stick with it. So So I'm not even going to take that out or anything. I'm going to just line up the rest of my edge and sew. Because that wasn't half bad, I don't think. That was a neat little way of testing, though. I've never done that before, like that. Actually sewn the little area. But see, it's not as obvious. You know, you can't just line it up because you do have to consider that you're going to lose that quarter inch on each side. All right, there we go. Oh, trying to fix the printer, that's never fun. All right, let's get little threads out of the way. Okay, and that is gonna be our strip. I think that's close enough. It could have probably gone up a little, but I think we're perfectly fine. Let's give it a good press. So there we are. Here is our first little shape. So you'll notice that my center line here is thinner than this purple line. And that's because this is that piece of fabric that I did cut a little thinner. So this one's less than that 3/4 inch. So all of them will be more like this. All the other ones I got to be 3/4 inch. But there, I think that looks pretty decent. So one of the steps I forgot to do on this, and I'm going to do it now, is I didn't grade the fabric on the back. And what that means, it's just a way to get rid of all this bulk. So here's where I forgot it. I forgot to do it on this piece before I sewed the middle piece. But all we're going to do is I'm going to take this top layer. So we got the two layers of the seam allowance here. I'm going to take the top layer of it. And you know what? I'm going to use my big scissors. I'm going to just trim away a little bit of it. And you know what? We're going to do it on the ground here. Maybe big scissors wasn't the right way to do this, but I'm just trying to get up to that point here. All right, there we go. So now I'm just trimming off a little bit, like an eighth of an inch for my quarter inch seam allowance, just on the top here, the top part of the seam allowance. And that's just going to reduce some of the bulk in the seam allowance. And I think this is done a lot in like clothing sewing. I haven't seen it too much in quilting, but you know, again, I'm do what I can do in quilting. I'm learning a lot with the Splendid Sampler. So here we go. So see, now I have, it's pretty choppy. I'll use a different scissors. We'll use an in-between scissors. How about that? But there, I've just made the one edge a little less than the outer edge. So then it's just, there's not as much bulk right on the edge. Like you don't get this stair-stepping like from two layers of fabric to one. You could just get, you know, the gradual little bit. So it'll make it feel a little bit flatter on the front. Like I can feel that seam allowance that we didn't do versus this other one just kind of slides off nicely. So that's what grading is. Let's just do it quickly for this side. I'm going to just cut this off. I don't need any of that. Just to get in here a little easier. Make sure that I'm only getting the top layer. So we'll do this for all the other ones. It'll take a little more time, and it's probably not really necessary, especially considering some of these other blocks we got in the Splendid Sampler with just a ton of bulk because I didn't cut anything down. But you know, it's fun to trying new things, and I haven't really done this ever. So there we go. There's our graded seam allowance now. So I forgot to do it for these, and it's kind of a little too late now. I mean, I could kind of do it up to here maybe, but I think screw it. I'll do it better on these other ones. So let's give this one final press. Just a really good flat. Okay. And this is going to be my big circle. So let's do that right away. Here is my big circle. And all what we're going to do now is we're going to kind of place this where we kind of want it. I think maybe down here is kind of fun. I like that it gets a lot of this blue in. And then I'm going to cut around my template, but I'm going to leave like a good generous, it says a generous quarter inch seam allowance. I'm going to give it like a good half inch probably. I'm going to go like around like this. So let's do that now. I can wait till I'm done with the other ones, but I kind of want to see it in a circle. And I think we might actually only get this far tonight. These other ones I think we'll have to do tomorrow because we are getting to the end of our time again. What I might do yet tonight is cut out my background fabric. So I'm going to just place this here. My spinny mat would be good for this too. So again, I'm just kind of doing a generous quarter inch seam allowance. It's actually a lot closer to a half inch. And this doesn't have to be perfect because this is going to be on the inside and we'll get a chance to like place this again a little bit before I do the edge. So it's a half inch in some places and a little less than a half in others. That's not going to matter. I'm just going to trim that off. Skinny. But this is at least the general, this is the process for these circles. I mean, we're not done. We still have to do the last step, which is stitch a running stitch around, and then we stretch it around the edge. So, all right, so there's kind of my first shape. It almost like that, like there's a whole nother one popping it in there, doesn't it? That's kind of a fun deal. It's almost like we have three strips, you know, two and then like one starting from the middle. But yeah, so what will happen next is we will take this and we'll just stitch a loose running stitch around the whole thing. And then when we put this, our little template on the back and we pull it tight, we pull on that running stitch, then all of this edge will bunch around our template, right? And then that's when we'll start to see our kind of circle come through, you know? So we'll do that next. Maybe we'll do that first thing next time, just so we can get like one, so we can kind of finish the process of a circle. And in her directions online, she also starched the edge when she went around. So tomorrow I'll get a little bowl of starch out and then maybe some cotton swabs and we'll just put starch right on the edge and we'll press that. And that's just to help get a really nice circle. See, look, like I'm just holding it there. It's already starting to be like a pretty circle around there. But yeah, so that's the plan tomorrow. So we'll start that first thing. We will finish up this circle completely tomorrow and then we'll move on to our other two circles and we'll kind of do them at the same time. Those will definitely go faster. So that's the plan. I think, we got a good start tonight. We have our templates all ready. We've gone through the process almost for one, and, I think tomorrow we should be able to get through the other two and the rest of this one, I'm thinking, at least, to the part where we're this far with the other two. We'll finish this one completely and then do the other two till they're at least this far. And then on Wednesday, we will deal with the bias strip and get however far we can on that. But this is a cute effect. I love that slashing technique. I think it's just really kind of freeing. You can just play around. And, you know, I think we got this good enough so it looks like this dark one's going underneath. So, all right, guys, I'm going to flip you around and we will finish up for the night. Hello. So here we are. Cute little circle. So this is the biggest one as well. So our two other ones are going to be like the small versions of this. Let me see if I can. Yeah, so here's like the size of the other two. And this one will get smaller too because we haven't wrapped it around the template yet. But I think it's going to be pretty cute. This is a really unique block. We haven't done anything like this yet in the rest of the Splendid Sampler, I don't think. We've done little parts of it, but this is kind of like a lot combined together. A lot of little steps, a lot of little fun things, though. So I'm excited. And we'll see if we can tackle that bias strip. I'm going to see if I can make or construct out of something that I have around the house that bias bar, because I've never seen that before. I thought that'd be interesting to try out. So we'll see how that goes. So that'll probably be not till Wednesday, though. So, all right, guys, thanks again for coming tonight. I'm hoping I don't, hoping this cold or mock cold doesn't get any further, because I want to still be able to do these in the evening. And this will go up on the Penguin and Fish movies. I'm still behind on that. I will get caught up, don't worry. And it will also stay here on Penguin and Fish. On the Penguin and Fish page, you can just do a search for penguin ampersand fish. Penguin and Fish crafters will come up, but so will the Penguin and Fish page, and it's on the Penguin and Fish page. Oh, Janet, no problem. And we're going to break down the rest of this block too. We'll get through this whole thing. All these blocks, you know, no matter how difficult they are, they're all doable when you break them down. Each just like do the first step, then do the second, and then eventually gets done, and this is one of those blocks for sure, and it's gonna be fun, it's gonna be cute, all these little circles. So, all right, thanks again, I will catch you Tuesday. Have a great evening, guys. Good night.